have gotten through pretty much the first solid half of this agenda. So we should move next to the vote for ratification of Sober Space. Mic check.
Mic check.
Sober Space.
Sober Space.
Simply means that. As a group.
As a group.
We don't smoke.
We don't smoke.
We don't drink.
We don't drink.
We don't do drugs.
We don't do drugs.
Where we are occupying. This is to ensure the safety of all those involved. In solidarity with one another. Anyone opposed?
To sober space.
I'm not opposed to sober space. I am opposed to smoking in a non-smoking in a containment area. It's just not real.
Mic check.
I am not convinced. That banning smoking of tobacco products
in a containment area,
i.e. our occupation site,
is practical.
Look around you. Half your forces will be off on cigarette break. I do agree, no drinking, no drugs, no violence. I do agree, avoiding smoking around non-smoking, maybe designating smoking areas of the campground. I do not agree banning smoking.
This point of information.
There is a human stack.
A queue of people. In line to speak.
If you'd like to speak.
Please join this queue.
What are we speaking about right now? Sober space.
I just like to quickly address the fact that we are.
Mic check.
I'd like to address the fact that we are a diverse organization. And that diversity includes choices to be a smoker
or non-smoker.
To bring your children or not bring children. Today I brought
my nine-month-old daughter,
and she has the right to not be exposed to cigarette smoke. Thank you.
So, what would you do? You have a suggestion, ma'am?
I think we should have
a designated
non-smoking area. For those who need it.
Mic check.
I propose
that we split the
sober space. Into two parts. One requesting. No alcohol or illegal drugs. And another part.
Requesting
a self-contained smoking area.
Or
however she proposed it.
So basically, I think I'm hearing the possibility of consensus around no drinking or illegal or drugs in our occupation zone. And then a split.
That allows for smoking and non-smoking.
Could I add to that? applies to the assembly zones also.
It applies to the assembly zones also.
That's the occupied zone.
That's the occupied zone.
Any other important points to that that don't go along with that? It sounds like there's.
Does anyone strongly disagree with this arrangement? All right, all those in favor? All those opposed? I believe that passes.
Yes.
We've got a strongly opposed.
Yes.
Good job.
Woo!
Good one.
There's one gentleman over there.
Strongly opposed having a segmented area for non-smokers to hang out.
Can't hear ya.
This is coming to consensus among the entire organization.
Can you tell everyone? I oppose.
Anyone taking away my right to decide whether or not I want to break the law.
Anyone taking away my right to decide whether I'm opposing the law. I should throw out a point of information that what we're voting on is the stance of Occupy Richmond as a group.
And I would like to point out that you asked me my opinion. I am just giving it to you.
I'm not trying to take away from your opinion, sir. I'm just saying that as a group, they've decided that this is the stance. It doesn't necessarily mean that if you...
I understand that.
You just asked me
all right, so moving on.
Moving on. We have modified consensus. The drinking and smoking bit is just ensuring that you minimize the likelihood of police interference. We can't take away whatever you want to do is what you want to do, but you have to think about how it affects the movement as a whole. What you do individually.
Hey, we should move on, guys.
I just asked a question, so didn't we just vote to make that part?
That was voted consensus upon, and if anyone else has anything like to say, there is open forum at the end of this discussion, so everyone can speak and have their feelings heard.
Point of order, since consensus was just reached, I would ask anyone, myself included, who is a nicotine addict, outside of main assembly, back where others who choose not to smoke are not in our smoke.
Okay, now next part of the agenda. Mic check. Working groups. A number of community members
have been coming together
over the last several weeks
to discuss
how we can make this happen. Working off the New York model,
they have established work groups.
These are groups of members without leaders
who come together to make stuff happen.
We've got media, sanitation.
Safe spaces and a number of others.
I encourage all of you.
If you want this to be successful,
to take an active hand
in one of these working groups.
These are imperative.
To the modified consensus model.
Of ensuring that everyone. Minority groups included. Have a say. To the entire General Assembly. And make themselves heard. There's a notebook going around. Where you can write down your name.
Email address, phone number, and skill sets.
And you will be put in contact. With these groups. If you're interested.
In starting another group.
You feel like something's not going right. Please do that. That's the only way we'll win.
My name is Emily. My question is just, can everybody hear me?
Yeah.
Emily, my question
My question is...
The contact sheet that just went around... Where all I was doing was putting my name... And my email address... Was I also supposed to... Indicate my skill set... And my interests...
Sure, and we will make these available after the meeting. So if you want to go back and...
And we will make these available after we gather.
Hi, everyone. My name's David. I just wanted to point out that... At Occupy Wall Street...
They use the human microphone.
Only because amplified audio is not legal.
Point of order. No, that's not the only reason. It builds unity in the group.
Mic check.
Can I finish?
But when we have to repeat after everyone, everyone gets sore throats.
We don't always agree, and it's good to have a microphone, if we have it we should use it.
Don't repeat it if you don't agree with it.
Are we going to talk about anything we want or just stay on the agenda?
I think that for now we should stay on the agenda.
Yes.
That way we can get to open discussion at the end. The microphone's not broken. People embrace the people's mics. So
It's a lot faster if we have a microphone. Mic check. As it has already been stated before.
We have to have patience here. Nothing's gonna happen in five minutes. This is a slow process.
The people's mic serves a purpose other than technical.
Besides just getting people to hear. We are all in solidarity with one voice.
When people think they don't need
the people's mic, and they think they can shout loud enough,
all they are doing is shouting.
And in this instance,
whether or not your words are aggressive,
or your intent is aggressive,
you are still shouting,
and that sounds aggressive, and is counterproductive
to unity and inclusion.
I propose we move on. To the next segment of the agenda. Which includes discussion. About locations.
Other issues.
If you have something to say about the final location. We have a human queue forming. And would love to hear what you say.
So this is not my idea.
But a friend brought it up.
And I liked it a lot more than the other ones we talked about before. And the idea is
That we occupy Monument Avenue.
Monument Avenue has
lots of statues.
Monument Avenue has lots of statues.
Of dead white assholes.
Of dead white assholes.
You all just said that.
You all just said that.
And also very wide grass medians. And while it is not the financial district, it is the home of a lot of very rich people. That is my promotion.
Woo!
Today I am speaking. For a friend who had to go to work. But he would like to bring up. The possibility of James Center Plaza. On Main and 10th Street. There is green space. No concrete walls. An open space. And it is halfway between. The governor's mansion and the Federal Reserve. It would be a good starting space. And it's outside of large bank buildings. And right in front of. The Bull and Bear Dining Club. Which is a high status. Restaurant for. Financial figureheads.
Question. Is that private? I heard that here. And is that also Bank of America Plaza.
Does anyone know? What are you talking about? The FedEx Plaza?
There is a public sidewalk there.
James River Plaza. It's private, yeah.
Oh.
I'll
take this down.
It's private.
So I'm hearing.
It's the Wells Fargo Bank.
It's the Wells Fargo Bank.
And I think I heard. It is private.
Can we confirm that?
The name.
The smartphones are working.
The name of the place.
It's the James Center Plaza.
There are public sidewalks that surround it. But public sidewalks don't really accommodate. The possibility of a large gathering.
Mike Jack. If you have not already. Sign your name and email information. Or checked into the Occupy Richmond website. In the next couple of days. We will post information. About these chosen locations.
On the itinerary.
That includes. Whether or not these sectors.
Private.
Government.
Or public.
We also include when they close
parking. Mike Jack. My name's Alan. I'd like to see Moe's inspiration or Moe's friend's inspiration.
I'd like to see Moe's friend's inspiration.
And raise it one. I agree that symbols count. That's why they're symbols. All those second place losers.
On Monument Avenue.
Deserve to have. A place down in. The Riverside. Where we can kind of dump that dead old history. Not symbolically. But really. If we're to succeed. We have to find something that's unique about Richmond. We don't have Wall Street.
We don't have
the great big golden bull.
a great big Vulcan
pole.
But
we have something.
Few
places on this planet have. We have our history. And we have our symbols. There is not a place on this planet.
That doesn't know.
Give me liberty.
Give me
death. We can claim that history.
That history.
As
our history.
I propose that we claim that history. Whether it's in St. John's Church. On outside.
On
this park across the street.
Libby
Hill.
Or Chimborazo.
It doesn't matter.
Where?
It matters that we claim that history. And reignite it. Just like Patrick Henry sparked a rebellion.
Against
the most ungodly things.
And brought down the mighty King George.
Words count.
Actions count.
Symbols count. We need to tap what makes Richmond unique.
And use that
against the forces that would destroy this planet. Let's claim it.
And I think the canal, whether it's legal or not, I don't know if it is. It may be somebody here can find out for sure.
If somebody can find out for sure
what our legal rights about taking over Canal Park is. Because I think that has two significant parts. Because it's the financial center here in Richmond. And it has an American Indian name as a park. A tribe that only lived maybe 20 miles upriver. And I think they're the ones that talk to us, the white people, the black people, all these people that live here in America. They're the ones that taught us about democracy. In the first place. Before any of us got to this land. So we need to show the world. That they're the ones that we need to give credit to and bring this world. Back to the way it should be. Because they were correct. And we're fucked up. That's all I can say.
It's like 20 seconds. It's beyond on behalf of Megan, who couldn't be here today.
My friend Megan
went to Kanawha Plaza and spoke to the people that are living there right now.
She was told
by the folks that live there that they had 90 days to vacate or they would be removed by the city. She proposes. That we occupy right along with them.
Well past 90 days.
In solidarity.
Plaza does in fact close at sunset.
But the people still sleep there.
I'm aware of that. If there's hundreds of people sleeping there, all of us can be arrested just for being there.
Oh yes.
Same with every other location.
Literally, every other location is the same.
They were told that.
Mic check.
Point
of clarification about
permitting.
For clarification about permitting.
I have gotten permits. Personally and with other groups. Many times. At Kanawha Plaza. Inside the Landmark Theater. That is where. The city gives out permits for such events. The last time. I got a permit. At Kanawha Plaza. They waived the fees. This is a viable place, and it is a place where some sort of permit can be received.
This is a viable place where some sort of permit can be received.
And this is where the homeless people over the past several years that I have known of have been directed and have been staying in large numbers. So it would not be precedence for us to be there as well. We would be standing in solidarity with the ultimate victims of capitalism. Yeah.
Hi. This is new to me, so. I'm Phil Waleto with the Defenders. And I was going to speak in favor of occupying the Kanawha Plaza next to the federal building. Because of the reasons that people are raising. But when Mo Khan from Wingnut made her suggestion, on behalf of the original suggester, I realized that Richmond has an opportunity to make a unique contribution. To this developing movement countrywide. Richmond is still known. As the former capital of the Confederacy. Even though that loser status lasted less than 3.5 years. But Monument Avenue.
Is praised today.
As one of the most beautiful streets. In the entire country. It's the only street in America. That has national historic status. And the only purpose of those statues. Was to reestablish the rule. Of the oligarchy. And a system of white supremacy. Decades after the end of the Civil War.
If we were to occupy that site,
It would be national news. And would lend a whole thrust of anti-racism. To what is still a predominantly white movement. It would say to hell with the 1% and their racist system. I think it's a great idea.
Monument Avenue doesn't close at dark.
Monument Avenue doesn't close at dark.
Does it?
No permit.
Point of information number two.
We might be facing a noise ordinance.
Since it is considered private property.
We are in the middle of a neighborhood.
The current Richmond noise ordinance.
Everyday conversation is in violation of it.
65 decibels.
65 decibels.
The people's mic doesn't even need to happen to violate it.
People's mic doesn't even need to happen for people to violate it.
Yeah, there are people in the music community and other communities currently fighting the Richmond Noise Ordinance because it, just like the previous one, is unconstitutional.
It's like
Logistically, Monument Avenue doesn't have the restrooms.
And if you put a large encampment,
of people,
that is your prime, one of your primary.
That is one of your primary considerations.
Point of interest.
Okay. I have a map with me right now. And saying that we set up on Monument Avenue. Is an excellent reason because of these reasons. Alright. Between Boulevard and 195. Is the prime location on Monument Avenue.
For these reasons.
From Broad Street, you cannot make a left.
On Boulevard to get to Monument.
That's correct. Also, there are only two main entrance roads that I know of crossing. Crossing 195.
In that area.
Probably within eight blocks. Therefore giving us more time to respond to any police action. Also, we have Arthur Ashe Jr. Monument. And Matthew Fontaine Maury. Within a four block radius of each other. Giving us plenty of opportunities to expand our movement. While we also have access to many of the other districts such as Carey Street.
Last point of information.
Before we enter work groups.
We don't have to stay in one spot.
That can change.
So now our next step.
In our meeting today.
Operating in solidarity with one another.
Let's break off into these work groups.
That explore these issues. I've got a list.
Media.
Legal Medical.
Those are separate.
Police Relations and Safe Spaces.
Facilitation.
Auxiliary.
Organization.
Kitchen.
We gotta eat.
And sanitation.
If anything's missing,
outreach, yes.
We had signs, but they weren't brought.
Nonviolent training.
Peacekeeping.
Sure, and we can get a list together after all of this. Yes, Joe. Education.
Internal communication.
Comfort.
Clothes, warm blankets, tarps, anything that you need to be able to survive out on the ground. Bring it if you got it.
Infrastructure.
That's what I would call that.
Well, in New York, they call it comfort.
Okay, we'll call it comfort.
Idea we might want to have a location before we break off.
Mic check!
We might want to have a location already picked. Before we split off into these groups. Because setting up for Kiowa
will be a whole lot different than setting up for Monument.
One
One speaking point. If we go down to Kenia Park.
We go down to Kenia Park.
Kanawha. There we go. Kanawha Plaza. If we go down there, we run into a problem. That's downhill.
That's downhill.
The big problem.
It's a big problem.
But it's a tactical disadvantage.
I think that we've kind of closed the location discussion for today, unless you had one last small point. Last small point.
Could I mention something around bathrooms? I think that we should not allow bathrooms to affect our decision on location, because sawdust buckets work really well as portable toilets. That's what we used in the Monroe Park occupation in March. And there's lots of ways to do DIY composting toilets using 55-gallon drums, etc. So let's not let bathrooms constrain our choices.
So there are a number of point people for each of these different committees who are here today. We've got Jake here with medical. Did you want to say
Mike check.
Mike check.
Will the medical team,
and
the safe spaces team, please come with me at this time.
Please come with me at this time.
Thank you.
Mike check. I heard the request. To look deeper into location. Before breaking off into work groups. Is there consensus that that's a good idea?
Yeah.
Does anyone oppose that idea?
You want to speak?
I propose that we come up with a good list
of workable locations
and stay ready
to go to any of those workable locations
based on a consensus
from the night of the actual occupation
starting here
At Monroe Park.
4 p.m.
On the 15th.
The reason for this.
Is if we pick something now.
That gives the police.
A full week. To meet us.
Woo! I'm just gonna emphasize something. What he's basically saying is, if you weren't here,
Mike check.
What he's basically saying.
If you weren't here at our first assembly,
through modified consensus,
we agreed
to decide on
the occupation location
on the 15th. Is that clear?
Is that clear?
Everyone agree?
Yep.
Point of order. Can we have some sort of cleaning of sentiment, a straw poll on the various locations currently under consideration.
Let's see where the sentiment lies.
One other location I'd like to just mention, and that is Belle Island. Although I think the first place would be Kanawha Park, but if there's another place, I think Belle Island might be a great place because it's a very beautiful place. It's also a very significant place where American Indians used to meet as far as Florida and Maine. They used to come here and meet on that island to give big powwows. If that's true or not, I don't know, but that's what I've heard. And I'm just saying it's a beautiful place to camp out and pitch our tent and hang out for weeks or months, which living in a park might not be that wonderful.
See Monument on Monument Avenue. That's where they live at. Right on Monument Avenue. At the Lee Memorial on Monument.
All right, hold on, time out. We got one question over here, and then I'll make another point.
Mike check.
I strongly oppose Belle Isle. Firstly, because there's only two exits off of that island.
Firstly, because there's only two exits off of that island.
logistic.
Two more.
Next week
is the folk festival.
Is the folk festival
on the Isle?
On the Isle.
I don't know that we can even do that.
So I don't know if we can even do that.
No, it's not.
It's Brown's Island.
It's on Brown's Island.
Oh, I'm confused. Forget it.
Mic check. Comfort will not be the most important thing. The goal of this is not comfort. It's to incite change. There's no change sitting on an island where people can't see us. I heard someone talk about west of Boulevard on Monument Avenue.
West of Boulevard on Monument Avenue.
I propose the east side. That is where the statues of Jeb Stuart. That's where the statue of Stonewall Jackson. That's where General Lee. Furthermore, it is more easily accessible. For not only VCU students. But for a walk if we're coming from this park. Like I said earlier.
Comfort
is not our goal. But we need a strong presence. And we need visibility.
You guys are all making good points.
Mic check.
Everyone here is making good points. We'll take one more comment, then we've got to move on.
I vehemently oppose a straw poll. Because public opinion can change in a week. And we can discuss this in the work groups. And I personally think we should move on to the work groups.
Let me emphasize that. This conversation is not closed. These topics aren't closed. Nothing is being made permanent right now. The important part of this entire meeting right now is getting these groups together. So let's move on.
Someone else
want to
talk?
Yeah. We're going to call the group up.
Questions?
One work group was called facilitation.
One work group was called facilitation.
What does that mean?
Facilitation is what these guys up here are doing.
Simply the people who keep.
Order and organization.
During large group meetings.
They are not leaders.
They are not decision makers.
They are facilitators.
Do they help facilitators to?
Abide by consensus of the group.
Yes or no?
Facilitators.
So do facilitators help reach general consensus?
No, help keep the order and the abiding by.
Yes.
Then I would request that you not be smoking at the moment.
Hey, buddy, give me that cigarette. I'm gonna light it back up later, man.
That's
my last one.
Get over there. You had a right to smoke. Get over there.
Auxiliary. They help everything.
Is anyone here part of auxiliary other than me? We're basically here to figure out where you need to go if you don't already know, and to just do other stuff that slips through the cracks. That is all.
Those who are part of the groups, can you raise your hand or let us know where?
Media? Raise your hands, media. Where's Tony?
Tony is on the medical team.
We'll be media right here.
Media
will be right over here, and kitchen and food will meet right here with David.
I'd like to suggest another category. I think I think we might try coordination, by which I mean we are considering several different locations to be. And I think it's also possible that we may have to move suddenly.
Yeah.
And as a large crowd, it might be advantageous to us to move suddenly in a rapid fashion without having people trampled or chaos happen. And this will take some practice or at least some framework.
Did anybody hear that? I don't think so.
I didn't.
Excuse me. I think it's a really valid point.
Wow.
Mic check!
Mic check!
I was suggesting another committee called coordination. So that as a large group gathers, in whichever location we choose, we will be able to move from that location.
Swiftly
and in organized fashion. Without having to trample
each other.
For example, if we came under actual attack. By the police. I think it would be more effective. For us to be able to move from that location. And set up somewhere else. So that they cannot remove us permanently from anywhere. But the logistics of doing something like that will require agreement and practice.
Could the coordination committee also do research?
On locations for next Saturday.
And make a suggestion. To the larger group. For consensus building. Does anyone oppose that kind of an idea, maybe?
Would you be willing
to start out as a point person? Hold on right now. Just a point of order that we have groups meeting, so I don't know if we really have a consensus right now because there are people that are unaware of the actions that we may be voting on right now. So that's my concern.
You don't have to just be in one group.
Right, you can be in multiple groups. I don't think anyone's making decisions right now. I think they're just talking about
we're not all together.
And I don't believe that this should be pushed forward while there's a group of people over there in a way right now.
We're just like, hey, who wants to do this? So Joe has a point of information real quick.
We should split off into our primary groups. We come back together.
Mic check!
We should split off into our primary groups. Come back together as a consensus. Talk very briefly about what we talked about. And then meet again in groups. To encourage people. To be involved in more than one group. Therefore, I want to start a meeting of the education group.
Which includes tutoring.
Helping students with homework. Right now, the people's library. Since there isn't a separate group for that. We're going to be meeting over there.
What's the People's Library?
is a model from New York.
Where people bring books.
To the occupation area.
So that during downtime,
People can both educate themselves.
And entertain themselves.
What are the other ones? Mic check!
Safe spaces is an area where you can go to calm down
and
talk to someone.
Just talk to someone.
If you're feeling overwhelmed.
If you're feeling overwhelmed.
As well as providing mental health resources. If you're interested in this.
If you're interested in this.
Let's move south.
Let's move south.
Okay. Mike Jack.
All right, imagine
outreach and networking.
Outreach and networking. Somebody
would be intended to get more people, to get more diversity,
to get the message out.
Anyone interested in working on that?
Find me.
So you'll set all bone.
Mike check.
Anybody interested in?
Cleaning stuff up. Come find me right there.
Come find him right there.
Mike check.
Facilitators.
We're going to meet right here.
Nonviolence training. Anybody interested in providing training for anybody that needs or wants it or is concerned with it? Meet over there.
Mike check.
Auxiliary.
Meaning everything that doesn't fit into anything else.
Legal.
Where is medical?
Medical goes off over there, gentlemen. Belong.
Medical. Education.
Dude, you understand my plan?
Yeah.